So we begin with social psychology. That is eighth unit. So which is one of my favorite topics. So what is social psychology, for that matter, of psychology which deals with how actually people think about or get influenced and relate to others. So because we are social beings, how we actually think and get influenced, or by actually how we relate to the groups, social groups, cultures, you name it. So ethnicity, we have got different social backgrounds, and how we interact and how we actually think about and how we relate is what actually social psychology. And here in the social psychology, we have got this syllabus. So in which nature and scope and history of the social psychology would be dealt first. And there are other theories and perspectives, and we'll be dealing with that as well. So to begin with, Floyd Allport given one of the definitions, that is, the social psychology is nothing but a scientific study of experience and behavior of individuals in relation to other individuals, groups, and cultures. So if I am an individual, for example, so how I'm interacting with other and how I'm interacting in different cultural settings. So in relation to certain individuals, groups, or culture is what actually Allport given the example, one of the definitions. So there is one more definition which was given after almost 20, 30 years. So that is by Gordon W. Allport. So what he suggested is that it's a discipline that actually attempts to understand and explain how the thought, feeling, and behavior of an individual are influenced by an actual imagined or implied presence of others. So whether either we imply that someone is present, for example, if there is a certain ethnicity group of people are present around us, whether they are there actually or implied presence or imagined presence would actually change the way we think and the way we feel. So how our behavior is changing with respect to that presence of others is what given by Gordon W. Allport. So this is a small introduction of social psychology, where it is emerged as one of the branches by the parents of psychology and sociology. So psychology and sociology are the parents for the social psychology, and where we have got significant number of facts which are coming from linguistic anthropology and ethnography and archaeology, different departments and their interpretations, given the various facts that actually put forth the social psychology subject. So social psychology parents, where you can remember as a psychology and sociology. So with this, we started with nature, scope, and history of the psychology, social psychology. So far, we have seen a small introductory video of our attempt, my attempt to really engage you guys with the topics and the discussion in the comment section. So I hope this introductory session will leave you with a thought and a feeling and an interpretation that I'm trying to put some useful aspect for our psychology community. So please keep following for the next parts of this UGC preparation series. Thank you.